Guys, my name is Russian Badger, and welcome back from Thanksgiving. Hopefully you enjoyed your trip to Fancoma and your probable increase in blood pressure, but even if you had kind of a terrible Thanksgiving, which I understand that some people have an unpleasant Thanksgiving, just look at the bright side that you survived Black Friday. For those of you that are in Europe or elsewhere in the world, Black Friday has kind of transformed the United States from, you know, it's a shopping day, into kind of just the Hunger Games, where people will kill each other for like a 99-cent crock pot or a toaster, so at the very least, just be thankful that you survived Black Friday. And beyond that, I'd like to let you guys know that I finally got those crying seal t-shirts made. Those of you from the stream who know the joke will get the joke, but a lot of you were bugging me for those crying seal t-shirts. I finally commissioned an artist and had them made. So if you would like to snag yourself one in the UK, EU, or of course North America, I will leave a link down in the description to those. You can go to the store, and I'm going to keep them 20% off through until Cyber Monday. So if you want to buy one for every member of your family, that's cool, but whatever. Now, when it comes to Battlefield, lately, I don't know what the deal is, but I have been having some very strange experiences. First thing, I can't really play vanilla anymore, because there's too many hackers. I think they're getting these free accounts, you know, during the free weeks, where they snag up all kinds of different accounts with different usernames, and then they follow me around. And this happens. It's not just like a regular aim botter or like a damage modifier. This guy found some kind of exploit where he can instantly kill himself and then respawn on me again and again and again in a permanent loop. So I don't know if he was trying to make it look like I was exploiting points or something, but I have to hand it to this guy. It's pretty hilarious. And I thought jumping in the water would somehow solve it, but as you can kind of tell when I, you know, plunge myself under the water here, it didn't really stop him. And, you know, I thought that was pretty weird for the longest time, but at least he's not aimbotting, alright? Like, there are some hackers, there were a lot of the hackers that have been following me around are just aimbotting outright just off these free accounts, but at least this guy's pretty creative. Now, I can't say the rest of the server is all that ecstatic because, you know, he actually gets rid of tickets every time he commits suicide on me, and I somehow went 0-1 with 21,000 points. If that's, yeah, seems legit, Badger, that makes sense. But when it comes to Final Stand, everything is even more morbid. So I don't know what the deal is, but everybody seems to have these really, really weird kits. And as you saw in the intro, you can now kill people with icicles, which makes sense in some instances, but not always. Like, just look at these kits though. Okay, so I pick up, the icicle is already kind of goofy enough, but okay, that if you want to pick up an icicle to stab somebody, I understand that. But why do you have a red dot and a suppressor? That makes no sense. I mean, the icicle makes sense because everybody wants to be Mr. Freeze, right? But sometimes it just doesn't make sense because, like, okay, stabbing with an icicle makes sense, but the whole slice thing, like slicing guys' jugular, unless you somehow sharpened your icicle without melting it into water, I don't know how that works. The only thing that tops that in terms of knifing animations, though, is this one. I have never seen this animation before, and okay, just let's watch it one more time. I stop his arm, right? Okay, just get ready to see this. I'm going to stop his arm. You're gonna see Hatsune Miku. I will 360 uppercut. So I stop his arm. All right, there's Hatsune Miku, 360 uppercut, take his tags and slice his neck. One more time, all right? So I stop his arm, and then I immediately see Hatsune Miku on his chest for some reason. But how do I 360 uppercut? What?
Oh, oh, oh. Oh, oh, oh. Oh,
And I know a lot of you are going to criticize the guy that I just knifed, saying, oh, nice Hatsune Miku emblem, nerd. But, like, there's no way that you can criticize anybody else's emblem when your emblem looks like that. Please. There's no way you have any room to criticize anybody else's emblem when you run around with that on your chest. All right? Please. Don't even get me started. And the only thing stranger than these icicles and these kits and these emblems and these animations and even, like, the bipod knife is just... I don't get the vehicles. Everything explodes. Everything explodes or it floats in the air. Like, allow me to save you 30 minutes of investigating exactly how the vehicles work in Final Stand. Allow me to just summarize it for you right here.
Boom! Michael Bay exploded! Bam! Boom!
And I thought that was bad until I saw an entire floating team. Just take me out of the oven. I am so done.